Club Kubo is finally out and we have some massive, to me, anyways, I think anyway, I think this is humongous, massive news. As we all know, we want information on the anime and it's been very scarce on whether it's coming out in 2021 or 2022, as you know, because there's fake articles that are always going out on the internet. Thanks GameSpot and IGN, you guys are awesome. Anywho, one of the most important aspects of getting any production committed to get an anime up and going is time, budget and scheduling. Those are important things. In part of pre-production, which we have talked about prior, which has already happened as we all know, pre-production also includes a time slot for TV, and the TV time slot can make or break a show. For example, Dragon Ball Z, when it first aired back in the 80s, I believe it was the 80s, there was more free reign to do whatever you wanted with Dragon Ball Z in terms of creativeness, whether that was gore, whether that was censorship, blah blah blah. And then obviously when they did Dragon Ball Kai, they had to remove a lot of stuff in terms of like blood and censor some things because it was going on a Sunday morning 9 o'clock time slot. With Bleach, however, Bleach was really kind of okay in that sense of scenario one because it was back in the early 2000s, but also because it was around about a 5, sometimes it changed, a 5 to 6 o'clock time slot, which isn't as bad, of course, as morning TV for kids, obviously. However, this was on a Wednesday and then changed to Thursday and then changed to Tuesday, I believe, something along those lines, or it did multiple channels either or, which wasn't particularly good in terms of trying to get, you know, the high school audience, because a lot of Japanese kids do extracurricular and usually they won't get home till about 6 or 7 o'clock anyway. So Bleach doing the numbers that it did within a weekday was really phenomenal for its popularity and compared to its predecessors. Anywho, the point of what I'm trying to say is, in today's standard, having an afternoon television show just wouldn't be enough for Bleach's Thousand Year Blood War, because literally it says in the name Thousand Year Blood War, and having censorship wouldn't be the best idea on this. Thankfully, the man, the mad lad Kubo, in his Club Kubo that got released today, actually answered a fan question. So let's read it, shall we? Somebody asked, in the anime version Bleach, the costume design of some characters such as Soifon, Yoruichi, and Haribel was different from the original manga. What do you think about that? Of course, if you don't know, Soifon, Haribel, Yoruichi all had censorships within their anime. Yoruichi and Soifon obviously had white cloth to cover any kind of side boob that Kubo did. Sad face, honestly, it's tragic. Honestly, it's tragic. There's a lot of potential there that obviously TV Tokyo said no to. And with Haribel, you had the bone plating under the underboob. So, I mean, it's not big censorship. It's censorship I think we can all deal with to some extent. Absolutely, it doesn't really impeach the story whatsoever. I mean, we had obviously stuff with like Matsumoto and her getting like her entire side getting ripped out by Aeon or Avon, however you want to say it. But we can do a whole video on censorship another time because there's lots to talk about in terms of censorship that really take away the impact of the story. And there's many parts in the Thousand Year Blood War which are going to be, well, you can't really have. I mean, look at Minazuki, Unohana. Unohana's Bankai, it's literally a sword of blood. And she disintegrates and restores Kenpachi over and over again. From a psychological level, it is impactful. And to censor it would kind of negate a lot of the psychological impacts of that mini arc, so to say. Or that character arc. Especially for Izuru. Izuru, that's all I'm saying. It speaks for itself. That's important in and of itself too. You can't really have the Thousand Year Blood War censored at all. And it was a big issue for many people because it was scary to think of. You know, even if the Thousand Year Blood War was animated beautifully, some of these censorships would have deteriorated the story as a whole. And I'm very happy to say that we are supposedly getting either a late night or a midnight time slot, which is fantastic because we're getting the same time slot as something like Berserk. Lol. And we're also getting a same time slot as Fire Force as well. I think also Demon Slayer also had a midnight release as well. So that's really, really good. Genuinely, that's fantastic. One Punch Man also had, I think, a 1 o'clock in the morning time slot too. So having a midnight time slot is really, really good. I wonder what day, but if it's a Friday night, it's a wrap. It is good to go. That would be amazing in terms of viewership as well. So Kubo then replies with this. And of course, bear in mind, it is Google Translate and Bing Translate and Yandrex Translate and other friends that confirmed that the translation was correct. So it may sound weird, but it is a correct translation. At the time, there was a rule in the Jump that only the end of the serialization work should be made into a late night anime. But now that it is said that it will be broadcast at midnight and follow the original manga is what is implying here. Also, the figurines of Haribel of Alpha Omega, the studio that did the Haribel figure, are based on the original. So yes, he's talking about the censorship of how the figures look are based on the manga, the original, and he's saying here that the broadcast will be at midnight and will follow the original look. Fantastic! I love that the question was based around side boob. However, it got the point across. We got a confirmation that at midnight we will be getting a Bleach time slot, which is, again, in terms of censorship, this is fantastic. This is exactly what we want. Trust me, it is exactly what we want and what we need. Awesome. That's all I have to say in terms of that. I'm very excited. Again, it didn't bother me as much with Soifan and Yoruichi, blah, blah, blah. However, when it comes to Blood, Thousand and Blood Arc, it is what we needed. So I am very happy. And you guys should be too. It shouldn't be an issue. If there is censorship, hopefully it will just be extremely minor. But yeah, it's good. It's good to go. It's good to go, boy. Especially when Aizen gets literally a fist through his stomach and he has no arm. Again, things like that give a severity to how much of this war is gruesome and it's not friendly. So there is other videos that I want to do in regards to this whole process, and there's going to be a lot more videos to come, dare I say, potentially daily. So of course, hit that bell, notification, and subscribe. However, short video, I know. Tell me your guys' thoughts, of course, in the comment section down below, how you feel about this. Hopefully, it should be good. I've always believed in Nakano, and I've always believed in Kubo. Kubo would not want his series looking like shit. I think everybody knows, the studio knows, Nakano knows that every fan wants this. There is a high expectation to have a Demon Slayer looking series, which is unfortunately what people expect now. Maybe it's a good thing or bad thing. We'll have to see how the industry adapts to that. However, everybody knows that this is a long project that people are passionate about and they want it. It's been 8 years. So having a midnight thing is so much better than you actually believe. And it gives more creative freedom. It lets, you know, the animators work their magic. And yeah, I'm extremely happy. You get to see. And I know the people are going to look at the thumbnail and thought that this was an Ichihime video. It seems like that was the case. It wasn't intended, but I can see where you guys are coming from now that it's been made and brought out to me. But yes, you will probably see Orihime's cleavage and Rukia's butt. Even though that isn't the point, unfortunately, a horny Japanese guy managed to actually give us an answer about the Bleach anime, and I'm all for it. So yeah, I'm gonna catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been Hansen, and as always, people, peace out.